both blades were going in the same direction. So let's try something. What if I just took one of these blades? Take this blade here. It's just held in with a nail. And I'm gonna flip the blade over the other way. Turn it the other way. No change. It still turns the exact same weight. To spin in opposite directions. You have to cut the blades, you have to cut the hubs at opposite angles. You can't just flip the blade over. So now I've got my two hub, I call them hub blanks, and I'll go and pop these in here, drill them with the drill press, and the holes will be centered. Dead center. I have a miter gauge extension with a C-clamp. Now this can get a little tricky because the C-clamp, when you're trying to go across the saw, the handle of the C-clamp here can catch and stop you unexpectedly. So you want to make sure that's horizontal so you can slide across the blade with your extension. So the extension has a quarter inch bolt in it. I just slide the bolt through the hub. I want to make sure that hub link is square. And I take a nut. Now you can just tighten that nut on there, tighten each one and run it through to make these cuts. So this is a wobble dado blade. And it has an offset hub that wobbles to make your dado cut. You can find them on eBay for $20. And I made a lot of Whirligig hubs with this wobble type of a dado blade. You see how that's gonna go across there? It's gonna cut on the bottom. I have this on 35 degrees. You want to make sure that this slot goes through the middle part. You don't want like a real skinny triangle here and a real fat one. You see, if you went over on the edge, it wouldn't be very strong. It has to be in the middle. See where the blade's going to cut it. You want to set the height, the blade height. So you don't want to cut into your hole. Make sure it goes below the nut, right here. Okay. That's pretty good. Get this out. Spin this around. Now, if I just took this other block and did it on the same side of the blade, these would turn in the same direction. Key point of this whole video, you gotta take it out. It's a pain. I'm taking the miter gauge to the other side, turning it to the other 35. Now you have to move all this stuff over. This has to go to the other side. You have to re-center everything. Here's the new blank, the opposite blank. Change the miter gauge to the other side of the blade. Again, you don't have to have this fancy wedge setup that I have. I just do this because it's quicker. You can just tighten the nut. It's not right here. Just tighten it with a wrench. That's ready to cut. Did I do this right? So I line the holes up on the same side and then see if I have a W or a V. Yes, these will turn in opposite directions.